हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी माउर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवलिया जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज वनफिया चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज क्लीवेज। क्लीवेज इज आल्सो नोन एज अ सेलुलेशन और सेगमेंटेशन। क्लीवेज ऑलवेज अकर्स इन जायगोट और वी कैन से फर्टिलाइज्ड एग्स और इन एक्टिवेटेड एग्स। Cleavage actually refers to the basically those mitotic division which lack G2 phase, and further these divisions are initially rhythmic, very rapid, successive and progressive. In developmental biology, cleavage is the division of cells in the early embryo. Why cleavage divisions occur at all? Actually, cleavage occurs to achieve multicellularity, to attain parental cell size, to increase the surface area, to obtain more oxygen, and to achieve the value of nucleoplasmic index to that of parental cells. So cleavage is a very necessary part in human being or other animals. Cleavage is a division of cells in the early embryo, which results in the compact mass of plastomeres, which is called morula, and morula later gets transformed into plastula. Cleavage, the first cleavage of the frog's egg was observed by Swammerdam in 1738. The term cleavage was given by von Baer. Now, planes of cleavage. Depending on the position of cleavage furrow, means how will it cut the egg. So depending on the position of cleavage furrow, the planes of cleavage may be meridional, vertical, equatorial or transversal. So first I will explain meridional. Meridional plane, assume that it is a egg. So when the cleavage furrow bisects the both the poles of the egg, that is a animal pole and vegetal pole. So because of this division, when the egg bisects both the poles of eggs, the egg get divided into two equal halves. Here you can see this is the egg and this is a meridional plane. So it is dissecting the both the poles of the egg, and egg is now divided into two halves. Example is first and second cleavage plane of frog's egg and first cleavage plane of chick egg. So here you can see this is a first cleavage meridional plane through meridional plane and the second meridional cleavage plane in frog's egg. Now second vertical plane. When the cleavage furrow lie on either side of the meridional plane, here this one or this one, so the cleavage furrow may lie on either side of the meridional plane. The furrow pass from animal to vegetal pole. The cleaved eggs plane of the cleaved planes may be unequal in size. It is the example is third cleavage plane of chick's egg. So this is a vertical plane. Now, equatorial plane. The cleavage plane bisects the egg at a right angle to the main axis. It lies on the equatorial plane and it again divides the egg into two halves. So here you can see when the egg bisects from equatorial plane. So the egg divided into two equal halves. Example is a fifth cleavage plane of frog's egg. So here you can see fifth cleavage plane of frog's egg. It is the equatorial plane. Now fourth is transverse or horizontal or latitudinal plane. It is similar to equatorial plane, but it lies on either side of the equator. So here you can say transverse plane. Yeah, it is parallel to equatorial plane. Example is the third cleavage plane of frog's egg. So these are the planes of cleavage. Cleavage planes are important to determine the fat of blastomeres of egg. Now, patterns of cleavage. There may be three patterns of cleavage. First is on the basis of amount of yolk and its distribution in eggs. The cleavage may be of two types: holoblastic or meroblastic. Then second pattern is on the basis of fate of germ layers. So cleavage are of again two types: determinate or indeterminate. Then third is a pattern of cleavage on the basis of arrangements of cell. Then cleavage are of three types: radial, spiral and bilateral. So first I'll explain holoblastic cleavage. Holoblastic cleavage, according to Balfour, the rate of cleavage is inversely proportional to the amount of yolk present in the egg. So the egg present in the egg disturbs the rate of cleavage. The rate of cleavage is a slow in that part of the egg in which yolk is more, and the rate of cleavage is fast in the portion of egg in which yolk is in lesser amount. So yolk, or the presence of yolk, decides which type of cleavage will occur in the egg. So first, holoblastic cleavage or complete cleavage. The holoblastic is again of two types: equal holoblastic cleavage and unequal holoblastic cleavage. Holoblastic cleavage means complete cleavage. Means holoblastic, in holoblastic cleavage, cleavage furrow bisects the entire egg, and it may be equal holoblastic or unequal holoblastic cleavage. So here you can see, this is the example of frog, or this this is the example of amphioxus, and in amphioxus equal holoblastic cleavage is present. So it is present in the microlecithal and isolecithal eggs, and cleavage leads to the formation of blastomeres of equal size. So when cleavage furrow passes through the egg completely, as a result the whole egg divides, and the egg divides into blastomere, and the no part of egg remains undivided. So equal holoblastic cleavage, amount of yolk is less and is distributed evenly in the egg. Cleavage occurs in the whole egg. Blastomeres are of same size. All the parts of eggs show same rate of cleavage. So here you can see, this is the egg first and secondly, which are meridional, then equatorial, and by divisions, blastomeres are formed, which are of all equal size. And then blastula is formed. Now, this is the unequal holoblastic cleavage. In those eggs in which amount of egg is medium, or we can say mesolecithal eggs, the cleavage leads to the formation of blastomeres of unequal size. Among the blastomeres, there are many small sized micromeres and a few larger sized micromeres. So, the blastomeres are bigger and lesser in number, where the concentration of yolk is higher in the egg, and the part of egg which contains a small amount of yolk, blastomeres formed are smaller and more in number, and the bigger blastomeres are called megameres or macromeres, and smaller blastomeres are called micromeres. So here you can see this is an example of frog, here egg. So these are the micromere and these are the macromere. So by division, many micromeres are formed and fewer macromeres are formed. Micromeres are smaller in size, macromeres are larger in size. But micromeres are more in number, macromeres are lesser in number. So it is present in the mesolecithal and telolecithal. Now, meroblastic cleavage. This cleavage is found in a megalecithal eggs in which amount of yolk is very large. And cleavage doesn't occur in that part where yolk is more. Where yolk is present, cleavage occurs only in the cytoplasmic part and the yolk will remain undivided. Meroblastic cleavage is of two types on the basis of distribution of yolk in the egg, that is discoidal meroblastic cleavage and the superficial meroblastic cleavage. So in discoidal cleavage occurs only in a blastodisc of egg. So here I am taking example of birds, because discoidal meroblastic cleavage is present in reptilian eggs and the birds' eggs. So here you can see this is the egg. And this is the dotted portion is showing yolk. And here, blastodisc. So, cleavage occurs only here. That is, cleavage occurs only in a blastodisc of egg. And this is mainly found in a megalecithal and polylecithal eggs like birds. Because in these eggs, cytoplasm is formed in the form of disc. So, it is a cytoplasmic disc or blastodisc, and cleavage occurs only here. So, it is a discoidal cleavage. Now, superficial meroblastic cleavage. This type of cleavage is present in a centrolecithal eggs, where the cleavage is restricted to the peripheral cytoplasm of the egg. So, here I am taking example of insect's egg. So, in insect egg, the central cytoplasm shows free cell division due to which so many nuclei are formed. So, these are the nuclei. All the nuclei migrate towards the peripheral cytoplasm and the cleavage occurs only in the peripheral region. So, this is a peripheral region. So, and because of this, a superficial layer of blastomeres is formed around the yolk. So, this is a layer of blastomeres. This type of cleavage is present in the centrolecithal eggs like insects' egg. Now, determinative and indeterminative cleavage. Determinative cleavage, when the blastomeres produce during cleavage are immediately differentiated and produce a particular type of cell or tissue then the cleavage is known as determinant cleavage or determinative cleavage. This type of cleavage is present in nematodes, annelids, mollusks, and so many other animals. Then indeterminative cleavage, if the blastomeres are undifferentiated, at least during certain stages of the cell division, the cleavage is known as indeterminate cleavage or indeterminative cleavage. This type of cleavage is present in echinoderms and all chordates. Determinative cleavage. In the determinative cleavage, the fat of blastomeres is fixed, determined. That is, each blastomeres forms a particular portion of embryo. If by any reason any blastomere is damaged or destroyed, then the part of embryo which would have developed from that blastomere will be totally absent. In determinative cleavage, the fate of blastomeres is not definite, not certain. All the blastomeres will form all the parts of embryo. If somehow some blastomeres are lost, no loss is observed in the embryo. If in the early stages of cleavage, the embryo is cut into small pieces, then each piece of embryo will develop into complete embryo and all the embryos are identical. And so identical twins are monozygous, and this is the basis of embryo cloning. Now, radial, spiral and bilateral cleavage. In radial cleavage, cleavage furrow are straight and forms right angle with each other. And in this case, first and second cleavage are meridional, which are at the right angle to each other. Third cleavage is equatorial. So in this way, eight celled octet is formed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1 is behind 8. So 8 celled octet is formed. So in radial cleavage, 4 blastomeres of upper tire and 4 blastomeres of lower tire are on the same plane. Means while blastomeres are arranged in a radially symmetry in the beginning. This type of cleavage is present in echinoderms and amphioxus. Actually, this type of cleavage is present in deuterostomia. Like echinoderms and some chordates are also included. Then spiral cleavage. The cleavage furrow here pass obliquely. In this pattern, 4 blastomeres of lower tire rotate clockwise or anticlockwise. If the rotation is clockwise, then it is called dextral spiral cleavage. This type of cleavage is present in mollusk. But if the rotation of lower tire, this is a lower tire. Here, this is a lower tire. So, if the rotation of lower tire blastomere is anticlockwise, means here, anticlockwise, then this pattern is called sinistral spiral cleavage. And this type of spiral cleavage is present in helminths and annelids. Now, third type of cleavage is bilateral cleavage. In this type of cleavage, first two cleavages are meridional in the same plane, and the third cleavage is transverse. So, embryo shows bilateral symmetry. Here you can see. This is a similar to this half. So, embryo shows bilateral symmetry in 8-celled stage. The blastomeres of one side are smaller and the blastomeres of other are larger. So, in this type of bilateral cleavage is present in tunicates, cephalochordates, amphioxus, cephalopod mollusk. So, this is a radial, spiral and bilateral cleavage. Now, laws of cleavage. First is the Balfour law, which I have already explained. The rate of cleavage is inversely proportional to the amount of yolk. Now, second is a Hartwig's law. The axis of mitotic spindle occupies the longest axis of the protoplast, and cleavage furrow tends to cut it transversely. Means if the two zygotes or eggs have a similar amount of yolk, then after some time or after some cleavage, the number of blastomeres formed will be same in size and shape. And yolk serves as a mechanical barrier in a cleavage division. The spindles, which are formed in the center of active cytoplasm, and the spindles are cut off at a right angle, that is a 90 degree to their longitudinal axis. So which is a Hartwig's law. Means it says that the cleavage, the rate of cleavage, the early cleavage division are synchronous because they exhibit typical doubling, that is a 2, then 4, then 8, then 16, then 32, and so on. But due to the effect of yolk, the later cleavage division becomes asynchronous. Now, Sachs' law. Sachs' law says that the plane of new cleavage or division is at right angle to the previous one. The cell tends to divide into equal size of the daughter cells, and each plane of division tends to bisect the previous plane at right angle. The blastomeres have a tendency to form similar cells. So these are the laws of cleavage. So today I discussed what is cleavage, what are the planes of cleavage, what are the patterns of cleavage. So cleavage may be holoblastic, miroblastic, determinate, indeterminate, radial, spiral, and or bilateral. Then I discussed three laws: Balfour law, Hartwig law, and the Sachs law. Now, what are the significance of cleavage? I've already discussed during first slide that it is very necessary to achieve multicellularity, to attain parental size, parental cell size, to increase the surface area, to obtain more oxygen, and to achieve the value of nucleoplasmic index to that of parental cells. So this is a cleavage. Thank you.